Being a professional photographer can be very satisfying, but at the same time, it can get extremely frustrating when someone is using your work without giving you any credits for it. So in today's video, I want to show you an amazing tool which will allow you to make a reverse image search to find out whether someone is using any of your images across the web without your permission. If you are not familiar with this term, a reverse image search is a content-based image retrieval technique. More precise, is the process of inputting an image that is suspected to be stolen and scouring the internet based on that picture. Now, before you jump to conclusions, this is not Google Images that I want to talk to you about. The tool that I'm about to show you is called CopySeeker, and it's so much better in many ways than Google Images or any other search engine that allows you to make reverse image searches. In order to use this tool, you need to head over to this website right here, CopySeeker.com. I'm going to leave a link in the description below for you to check it out, so you can just click on it and save it on your bookmarks for future use. Of course, if you found it useful like I did, bear in mind this tool can be used from PCs and from any other mobile devices as well, like smartphones or tablets, but we'll get to that later on. Now, straight from the start, you can see that the interface is very intuitive by offering you three clear options to search for an image, so you can either drag your picture in here or browse through your folders and select it. You can insert the URL of an image you found online and search for it, or you can even select images straight from Instagram. And each one of these options is very helpful based on your needs. Like, for example, if you want to search for an image that you store locally on your device, you can just use the first option. Or if you want to search for an image that you found online, like let's say this picture right here, you can simply right click on it and select copy image address. And what you want to do next is go back to the CopySeeker website, paste the URL in here and click on submit. Now you might notice that the search takes slightly longer to complete than the one on Google Images, but the results are way more accurate. And rather than seeing all kind of similar images, you will see at the top the results that match your picture, even though some of them have been modified, like this one here or this one. Also, what's really cool about these search results is that they are sorted by the website rank, and you also get a direct link to the image found. So for example, if you want to stop someone from using your pictures illegally, you can easily find the major websites that get the most traffic and focus on them rather than going for the small ones that are most likely not getting any traffic. And you can do that with the touch of a button. Well, that's a few more buttons, but you get the point. You can insert your name and email address in here, press confirm, and someone will get in touch with you in order to verify your claim request. And in case of a real copyright infringement, their lawyers can file a DMCA takedown notice. The third option to search for images seems pretty unique and I really like it. So let's say you post a lot of your work on an Instagram profile. You can click on this button that says select from Instagram, insert your username in here and press next, and you should see your Instagram pictures in here. So you can pick one and CopySeeker will search for it over the web. Now, as I mentioned at the beginning of this video, you can do this from a mobile device as well. So if you are using an iPhone, all you have to do is open Safari or whichever browser you are using and head over to their website on copyseeker.net, and you will see the same three options like on the desktop version. So you can upload your image, select from Instagram, or paste your URL in here and press submit. And what's even better, if you press the share icon and select add to home screen and press add, an icon will be added to your home screen, so you can launch the tool from here, just like you would do with a normal app. To do this on Android, again, you need to launch the Chrome browser and head over to their website, and you can use their tool from here. Or if you want to run it like an app, like I showed you on iOS, you can tap on the three dots in the top right corner and select add to home screen, press add, and you will see an icon being added in there. So you can just launch the app from here. Again, this is so much better than using Google Images, where you would have to request the desktop website and then trying to find a way to submit your pictures and so on. I hope you found this video useful. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and let me know in the comment section which feature you like the most. And if you are looking for an easy way to transfer your iCloud photos to Google Photos, check out this next video where I show you how to do that.